Chapter 7, Limit at Infinity. Learning outcome for this lecture. At the end of this lesson, students should be able to determine limit fx over gx when x approaches infinity, when limit fx x approaches infinity and limit gx x approaches infinity are undefined. Use the theorem for n greater than 0. Limit x approaches infinity 1 over x to the power of n equal to 0 and limit x approaches negative infinity x to the power of n equal to 0. Okay, let's see. Limit at find limit x approaches infinity fx and limit x approaches negative infinity fx. A, fx equal to 1 over x squared, and b, fx equal to 3 over x squared minus 5 over x cubed. Okay, for question A, fx equal to 1 over x squared. Okay, we find limit x approaches positive infinity 1 over x squared. We know we must substitute infinity in x. We get 1 over infinity squared, and infinity squared is infinity. Okay, 1 over infinity, the answer is 0. Look at limit x approaches negative infinity 1 over x squared. Okay, we substitute a negative infinity in x. We get 1 over negative infinity squared. Negative infinity squared is infinity, and 1 over infinity, the answer is 0. Okay, for question B, fx equal to 3 over x squared minus 5 over x cubed. Okay, let's see limit x approaches positive infinity 3 over x squared minus 5 over x cubed. Okay, substitute infinity, we get 3 over infinity squared minus 5 over infinity cubed. And we simplify, we get 3 over infinity minus 5 over infinity. 3 over infinity is 0 and 5 over infinity is 0. 0 minus 0, the answer is 0. Okay, limit x approaches negative infinity 3 over x squared minus 5 over x cubed. We substitute negative infinity in the question. 3 over negative infinity squared minus 5 over negative infinity cubed, and negative infinity squared, we get the answer is infinity, and negative infinity cubed, we get the answer is negative infinity, and we simplify, we get 3 over infinity plus 5 over infinity. So the answer is 0. If limit x approaches infinity fx over gx equal to infinity over infinity, then we will to divide the numerator and denominator by the highest power of x of denominator. And infinity over infinity, we don't know the answer, or we can say that infinity over infinity is indeterminate form. Example 5, find a limit x squared plus 1 over 2x squared plus 1 when x approaches infinity, and b limit x squared over 3x minus 1 when x approaches negative infinity. For question A, limit x squared plus 1 over 2x squared plus 1 when x approaches infinity. When we substitute infinity in numerator, we get infinity squared plus 1, and the answer is infinity. For denominator, also we substitute infinity in x squared, 2 times infinity squared plus 1, the answer is infinity. So we must divide the function with highest power of denominator. Look at denominator and can see that x squared is the highest power of denominator. So we must divide all terms in this limit with x squared. X squared divided by x squared and 1 also divided by x squared. 2x squared divided by x squared plus 1 divided by x squared. X squared divided by x squared, we get 1 plus 1 over x squared is 1 over x squared. 2x squared divided by x squared, we get 2 and 1 over x squared is 1 over x squared. And when we substitute infinity in this limit, we get 1 plus 0 over 2 plus 0. So the answer is 1 over 2. Okay, for B, limit x approaches negative infinity x squared over 3x minus 1. And let's see the denominator for this function. Denominator is 3x minus 1, and we know x is the highest power of denominator. Okay, we divide this term with x, so x squared divided by x over 3x divided by x minus 1 divided by x. X squared divided by x, we get x as an answer, and 3x divided by x, we get 3 and minus 1 over x. And when we substitute negative infinity in x, we get negative infinity over 3 minus 1 over negative infinity, and we simplify, we get negative infinity over 3 plus 0. And negative infinity divided by 3, the answer is negative infinity. We know that when limit x approaches negative infinity, the answer is negative infinity. So we said that limit does not exist.